The Fire John Boehner Challenge. I'd like to thank my friend Chuck Suter for coming up with this idea that we can use to help spread the message about why we as conservatives do not want to see the re-election of John Boehner as Speaker of the House. So here goes my top three reasons. Number one, the man's a liar. When it comes to promising members of the House that, for example, they'll be able to read a bill before voting on it, the man simply cannot be trusted. The same is true with negotiating with other members in his own caucus, saying, if you vote for me on this, I'll make sure that I give you that in the end. Multiple times, and multiple members have suggested that he's gone back on his word. That, frankly, is not a sign of leadership, and not something that I want to see representing my point of view in the House of Representatives. Secondly, tactics. A tactician, he is not. You never enter the negotiating table by laying all of your cards down and saying what you're willing and not willing to do. And this has happened, for example, over the debt ceiling and shutting down the government. The man has come and said, this is what we're not willing to do. We're not going to shut down the government. Well, at that point, you've already caved. You've lost all of your negotiating power because the other side knows that you're no longer willing to play hardball. That is not a sign of leadership when you do not know how to advance your cause. And that brings me to the third point, is that the man simply isn't a fighter. Now sure, the rhetoric at times can be really good, but it reminds me of the Shakespeare quote, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. We certainly have a lot of show votes, but when the you-know-what hits the fan, and it's time to actually vote to get something done, you'll see Speaker Boehner running and claiming we need bipartisanship, and what we need to do is work with the Democrats and work with the other side to get things done. If you truly believed in the ideas that you're espousing, you wouldn't be so willing to throw them away when it comes to actually standing for something. So, there's plenty of other reasons I could get into. I would like to end with this, though. Somebody on one of Chuck's comment threads suggested that unlike the ice bucket challenge, where people had to like dump some cold water on their heads, something silly to help this go viral, this was lacking that. So hopefully before this gets too far, I would like to suggest that at the end of everybody making one of these videos, that you all unite with me in singing a song of praise in the language of John Boehner's people. Thank you. Now, I'm going to nominate my caution friends, Dennis Peterson, Catherine Oxford, and Mel Morgenstein, to give this a shot, and let me see what your reasons are for not wanting John Boehner as Speaker. And if you don't have a video camera, don't worry, I'll bring one on Monday. So thanks, guys, and here's to liberty. Cheers. Bye.